What the fuck? Is that true of you right here with another top 10 list? Certainly is. Well, it's been a while since we've had a True Review Zone, so here we have my own top personal 10 visual novel favourites. Just to make this as clear as possible, because believe it or not, but there have been some confusion over past True Review Zone lists, but this is a list of my own 10 favourites, rather than the best 10 ever, so please, 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 for all of those retards out there, this is my own personal top 10 choices, okay? But as for the rest of you who already knew that, apologies. Fist bumps, and here, have a Twix. And let's get this list going. Oh, and only one per franchise. Hit it! Metal Gear Solid 3! Just kidding, I wouldn't really do that. Corpse Party, Book of Shadows. Now, you know we've got a good list going on when we're starting out with a bit of Corpse Party. However, although I'll probably go with the first game in the series as my personal favourite, its gameplay was only half visual novel and half RPG Maker-style adventuring. However, the second game in the series, that being Book of Shadows, was purely a visual novel, so here it is at number 10. Having heard about the Sajiko Ever After spell that will grant those who participate eternal happiness, a group of high school students are shocked to learn that the charm was actually a curse. Having failed to perform the spell properly, the students and their teacher now find themselves trapped in a nightmarish box dimension with no hope of escape. The story plays out from several perspectives, as you see some of the other characters cheat death and bring hope to the group, while some will die a death so horrible they'll freak you out even after you've turned off the game. Had it not been for the numerous beginner's traps that'll lead you to a bad ending several hours after making the wrong choice and not knowing it, then this game could have made it higher on the list. But it made it in all the same. Chaos Head. Takumi Nishijo is a high school student with not much going for himself. He's antisocial, extreme otaku, and has incredibly low self-esteem. But after becoming interested in the next-gen serial murders, Takumi receives a strange email from an anonymous chatroom user. The email contains details and pictures of murders that have yet to happen, and things start getting weirder after Takumi realizes that this informant can see into the future. But if that's not bad enough, the person he suspects of being the next-gen killer happens to be a mysterious girl who seems to know him. The first half of this novel is fantastic, as it really makes you wonder what is real and what is a delusion, keeping the player guessing and hooked. The second half, on the other hand, I felt got a bit stupid, as it decides to throw out the mystery and instead gets a group of high school girls to fight each other with big swords. And that's fine if you like that sort of thing, but yeah, I felt it was a bit out of place, but it's still an interesting read despite that. Katawa Shoujo! I really hope I pronounced that right. Whoops if I didn't. I can't remember who it was, but one of you guys recommended this game to me. And thank you so much for doing that, because I absolutely loved this game. After being diagnosed with cardiac arrhythmia, you begin to believe that your life has come to an end. However, this notion soon gets blasted out of the water as you are sent to a special school that caters for students with different physical and emotional disabilities. You go to classes, make friends with the psycho that lives next door to you, and inevitably fall in love with one of five girls that you encounter. This is a story of struggle and triumph. It's a story about a boy who has lost everything, but through his own hard work and perseverance, gains more than he could have ever hoped for. The novel is categorised as eros, and to be honest, there are some sex scenes, however you do have the option of turning it off if you want. But then again, if you're interested in seeing an awkward anal sex scene with a girl with no legs, then by all means, leave it on. You dirty bastard. But even putting aside the porn, this novel will pull on your heartstrings on several occasions, and is a truly wonderful story. Goodman. Clannad! Speaking of pulling on your heartstrings, how about a bit of Clannad? For those of you who have watched the anime, then you'll know almost everything there is to know about this game, but for those of you who don't, then let me fill you in. You play as Tomohiro Kazaki, a high school student, of course he is, who has become bored with life. He shows up to school late, often skips classes, and doesn't engage with his drunk/tryhard father. But then one day, Tamura encounters a girl named Nagisa Furukawa, a shy girl with a strange habit of saying the name of a food she likes in order to give herself courage. Intrigued by her strange yet gentle nature, Tamura decides to get to know her and helps her overcome her anxieties by encouraging her to be more outgoing and trying to restart the drama club. At this point, you'll begin to meet the rest of the cast, and through your own actions and choices early on in the game, you'll be locked into a particular story arc, focused around one particular character. This novel is meant to be played several times. In fact, if I recall, you'll need to play it about 13 times in order to have covered everything. However, though this might seem a lot, it is time well spent. This novel knows how to play with your emotions. It'll have you laugh 1 minute with a light-hearted comedic scene, but will then throw many emotional curveballs at you, including some major bombshells that you won't see coming, which could very well bring you to tears. Clannad might not be the most macho of VNs, and so some of you might just walk past this one without a second thought, but I can't tell you enough how much of a disservice you'll be doing to yourself by missing out on this title. It's a must play, and so here it is at number 7. Fate's Day Night. The Holy Grail War. A secret war fought between the world's most powerful mages. For centuries, an elite society of mages have managed to hide their existence from the world, and only the brightest of society, or the oldest magic-using families, are aware of the existence of magic. However, once in a blue moon, the Holy Grail from legend begins to materialize. Those who possess the Grail are able to have any wish they want granted. However, to obtain it, the Grail must choose you, and only 7 people can fight for it. In order to decide the winner, the 7 chosen mages must fight each other in what's become known as the Holy Grail War. To fight these battles, each mage, or master, is allowed to summon a heroic spirit from history to fight for them. The story follows Shiro Emiya, a novice of magic who can't even be considered a mage. But on one fateful day, by pure accident, he summons the noble and beautiful servant from the Saber class of heroic servants known only as Saber. Now firmly involved in the Holy Grail War, Shiro must make alliances with other masters and attempt to defeat the others all in the name of justice. Containing different endings and paths to follow, the story of Fate's Day Night includes brutal conflicts against your fellow students and famous real-life historical figures, unlikely friendships being made with unlikely characters, as well as learning about the main character himself. Fate's Day Night is a thrilling read that will not bore you even for 1 second. Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Show me someone who isn't aware of the Ace Attorney series, and I'll show you someone who doesn't play video games. Phoenix Wright is a rookie defense attorney with a lot to prove and practically no experience under his belt. But never does Wright have a dull moment, as potential clients start piling up. All charged with murder in the first degree, Phoenix must investigate each crime scene, gather clues, listen to testimony, and bring the truth to light in court. I'd say that the gameplay is 90% visual novel and 10% clue gathering, but the highlight of each chapter is most certainly the events that take place in court. You'll have to listen to key witness testimonies and show the relevant evidence to contradict their flaws with the infamous phrase, objection. The series sure does love its plot twists though, with some being quite cleverly thought out, though some are at times ridiculous. But nevertheless, Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney is here at number 5. Higurashi, When They Cry. The series that I'm all about right now. I only discovered this a few months back after I got the first story arc on my phone, and then I've been living this series ever since. Set in June of 1983, the story initially follows Keiichi Maibara as he transfers to the small rural village of Hinamizawa. He soon becomes friends with a group of girls and enrolls with the local school, and everything seems fine and fun to begin with. However, he quickly discovers that the village holds a dark secret known as the Curse of Oyashiro-sama, where on the night of the village's big festival, one person will die and one person will disappear. But if that's not shocking enough, Keiichi also discovers that the most likely suspects for this sinister tradition are actually his new group of friends. As his new friends become suspicious of him, Keiichi must now try to solve the series of mysterious deaths before the curse claims his life too. The overall story is told through 8 different story arcs, where the plot resets at the beginning of each chapter, allowing you to see the plot play out from a different perspective, as well as seeing different events play out. This has been described as a sound novel, where the game focuses on its soundtrack and sound effects to set the tone and is able to pull it off in an impressive way. For those of you who are familiar with the anime, which is also awesome too, I'd highly recommend playing the novel as well, as there are certain twists and revelations that appear to be more shocking there than in the anime. Each story arc begins in a very innocent manner, with all the characters having fun and enjoying each day. However, the plot always takes a very dark turn for the worse, as that all-familiar feeling of dread and impending doom soon falls upon us. A novel that somehow manages to freak out the reader without a single word being uttered, Higurashi When They Cry is by far one of the most underrated visual novels ever. It's 3 a.m. I must be lonely, huh? Virtue's Last Reward. Didn't I mention this in the last video? Oh yeah, I did. Well, I never really explained the synopsis, so I guess we're cool. The second entry in the Zero Escape series, you play the part of Sigma, who has been suddenly kidnapped and have awoken in an underground complex with 8 other strangers, and everyone is wearing a bracelet with the number 3 on it. You're told that you're trapped in this facility for the rest of your life. The only way to escape is to raise the number on your bracelet to 9, so that you can open the number 9 door and escape. The only way to raise your number is to play the ambidex game. Split into teams of 3. One pair must enter one room, whilst the other enters a different room. Inside each room is a computer terminal with the options Ally and Betray on them. Should both teams pick Ally, both teams gain 2 points. If both pick Betray, then no one gains any points. However, if one side picks Ally and the other picks Betray, the side that picked Betray will gain 3 points, whilst the team that picked Ally loses 2 points. Should the number on your bracelet reach 0 or negative numbers, a powerful toxin is injected from your bracelet into your veins and you'll die. The game is divided into 2 sections. One half is a visual novel, where the story progresses, whilst the other half focuses on logic-based escape room scenarios. If you watched my last video, then you'll also be aware of the game's story flowchart, where picking one option will lead the story down a different path, and should you reach a dead end or you die, then you'll have to go back to the flowchart and go back to the point where you made your initial decision and pick the other option. This game's atmosphere is worth noting, as there's this unexplained feeling that something terrible and shocking is right in front of you, but you'll have no idea of what it is. A long game, but very, very enjoyable, Zero Escape Virtue's Last Reward is here at number 3. Danganronpa 2 Goodbye Despair. Now that I think about it, I mentioned this in the last video as well. Sorry, I'll leave these two franchises alone for a while after this. Some of you may be surprised that this isn't in at number 1, but that's only because not all of it is a visual novel, as some sections break away from the genre. 16 students from Japan's most prestigious high school have awoken on a tropical island. Told that they're trapped here forever, their only hope of escape is to murder one of their fellow students and get away with it through a class trial. If the killer's identity is revealed, then that person will be executed. But should an innocent student be branded as the killer, then the killer will be allowed to leave, whilst everyone else will be executed. Much like Virtue's Last Reward, this is by the same developers if you haven't already guessed, the game is split into 2 sections. One side is the visual novel where most of the story takes place, but the other half consists of finding clues, and much like with Ace Attorney's classroom sections, the class trial will consist of listening to other students' testimonies and throwing the correct piece of evidence at them to punch holes in their arguments. Despite being presented in a bright and wacky anime style, the series is actually really fucking dark, where the game will go to great lengths to establish a varied and lovable cast of characters, and then spends the rest of the time systematically killing them off in horrific and bizarre ways. I'm going to go with the second game above the first, as I honestly believe that Danganronpa 2 beats the first one in everything except for atmosphere. Fans of this channel are probably sick to death of me covering this game by now, but it's only testimony to how good it is, and should be played if you haven't had the chance yet. It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Got your hand on the side and said I'm angry. Steins Gate! And last, but certainly not least, we have the critically acclaimed novel that is Steins Gate in At number 1. Set in 2010, the story follows Rintaro Okabe, a self-proclaimed mad scientist and college layabout who, along with two of his friends, have turned his one-room apartment into a lab. His goal is to destroy an evil organization that he's made up in his head, called simply The Organization, and to reduce the world into a state of pure chaos and anarchy by creating new gadgets and devices that are, in practice, really, really useless. However, on one fateful day, the members of the lab accidentally turn their microwave into a device that can send text messages back through time. They begin to test this device to improve their lives and the lives of the new lab members who everyone quickly becomes friends with. However, Okabe's fantasies are not as ridiculous as we are led to believe, as an international technological company known as CERN gets wind of Okabe's creation and now attempts to steal it for themselves in order to rewrite history and to install their company as a global dictator. With all of the lab members' lives on the line, Okabe must now undo every message and time change that has occurred up until this point in order to save the world from a dystopian future, as well as saving the lives of the people he has come to love. Given the choice between this and the anime, I'd have to recommend the novel, as there are many scenes that you'll not be familiar with that fleshes out different characters' backstories and how they are affected by the time shifts, but there are also multiple endings as well, most of which are bittersweet. Steins Gate is a tale that will make you feel every human emotion that you can experience. You'll laugh, you'll cry, you'll get angry, you'll feel terror, and you'll most certainly fall in love with this product, and that's why there is no doubt in my mind that Steins Gate should be in at number 1 on this list. And that's all we have this time, but if you'd like to be number 1 on this list, then like and subscribe for more shit. Oh, and there's Twitter and Patreon, and yeah, see ya!